5, 4, 3, 2.
Coming up next on the Jeff Crilley Show, we'll be talking to one of the honorees of the 2020 Dallas Business Journal's Women in Technology Award. That's just ahead.
Many are predicting that the worst is yet to come, which is unfortunate, said one person here. Until now, they've enjoyed the reputation of being the nation's icebox.
Watched a burglar in his home this morning by webcam.
As a journalist of over 25 years, stories are what make my world turn.
Reporting live from the Dallas newsroom tonight, Jeff Crilley, Fox 4 News.
But in 2008, I took the jump from my familiar life and started a PR firm from my home.
We're talking about anyone with a camcorder like the one I'm using becomes a television network.
We started slowly growing the company, and we now have over 100 clients, and we've branched into the world of live digital broadcasting. I now own 8 different TV studios and have a huge team, and the stories that I now get to share are sometimes the most important of my life. Life has a funny way of coming around full circle. This is the Jeff Crilley Show.
Well, the pandemic has been challenging for companies across the country. Some are hunkering down. Others are thinking about expanding. And to talk about that today, Sarah Reid, she's the principal of research and design with Dialexa here in Dallas. Thank you for coming on the show.
Thanks so much for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Yes. Well, one of the things that we'll be talking about in a minute is a great honor that you received from the Dallas Business Journal, Women in Technology. But first, let's talk about the company. What is Dialexa?
So Dialexa is a research firm focused on technology, and we call ourselves blue-collar consultants because we're able to get in and not only help you with your strategies of product, but be able to do the dirty work of design and delivery. And that's my favorite thing about it.
Well, and your part with research and design, tell me what your role encompasses.
Yeah, so that encompasses making sure that the user experience is seamless and great. So if you're using your app and you're frustrated, that's usually a fault on my team, making sure that we understand how you're going to use it and how to make it seamless. And we work with the delivery technology folks to make sure that they can build it, and we work with the business to make sure it's a good business decision, right? You can design pie in the sky things, but we want to make sure that it's something we can build and get out the door so you guys can have, we can all have a better life using the technology.
And I know that your company has a wonderful workplace culture, and that's one of the reasons it's been so resilient during COVID.
Yeah, that's something that I've really been appreciative of us during COVID, is because at the beginning of it, it was nerve-wracking. We put clients on hold. We respected that, you know, people had to go through certain times. A lot of budgets were on hold as well. But I really appreciated how the team and the company together banded. And we all took certain pay cuts. We looked at the programming and the offerings that were out there for us. And we were able to work through that and work through that challenge. And I'm really happy to say that through it, we hired 50 people.
That's
we
impressive.
Gained new clients. The clients we put on pause were able to come back. So it was really something that I thought was in the fabric of the people here, that we could rely on each other and that we could provide a place for new people to come and grow and build. And so that's something I'm really proud of for our company. And I think that's really cool.
It is a very cool company. We found a nice video that gives a little bit of an overview. Let's go ahead and roll that now. Wow. Okay, we should point out that was shot pre-COVID. That's why we didn't see a lot of masks. But what a cool company. In fact, you're going to have to invite me to Waffle Fridays.
Yes. And some people there, Simba was in the kitchen. He'll make you waffles.
Really?
He's the one who started it. What I love about that clip is that's our CEO. He just took his camera and started recording it. So none of that is pre-recorded. Like, that's really what we weren't told about it. Some people are giving him weird looks. Like, that's exactly how we do work and how we like to work together. I mean, granted, pre-COVID. While we've been in COVID, though, I would say that amount of collaboration has still been there. We've been great at using digital solutions to be able to connect with each other, and we're definitely a cameras on type company because we enjoy that human connection and that deep collaboration to get stuff done. It makes work fun. Like,
and I know why you guys are expanding so rapidly. Yeah. Waffles and beer.
Yes.
So I noticed beer in the fridge there. Yes. That's what a cool company. Let's go back to the award that you won, and we're going to go ahead and put a clip on the screen. Gosh, great picture of you. Did that feel like to win?
That was it felt awesome, right? It felt great to be awarded and acknowledged, especially when in my day-to-day, I don't think about the things we've accomplished. Like, I've been with this company since we were 20-something people, and we're now 150.
Wow.
And so it's just winning this award was a great acknowledgement for the work I've put in, the work my teams have put in to transform this and make great products and deliver great solutions for people. So I felt very honored and appreciative of the award, and especially honored within my colleagues that were there. I enjoyed getting to meet them and talk to them virtually about their companies and how they've been looking at COVID and their challenges they're facing.
So I'm so impressed by the growth of your company, because we keep hearing stories on the media about companies that are shrinking and going away, and mm-hmm. yours is actually in kind of a rapid expansion mode. What do you attribute that to?
I attribute that to partly we have, part of it is I think our resilience, our ability to work hard and still be able to deliver on those solutions. But I think also part of it is COVID made people accelerate their transformation. Beforehand, people were kind of talking about, I want to do in-store and in-person as well as a digital solution, and we need to figure out how to make that seamless. That was a lot of the conversations with our clients. And once COVID hit, it was, no, we really need to figure out this digital transformation, and we really need to figure out how we can provide better experiences online, because we haven't been investing in that, and that's costing us money.
Yes.
Because other folks are figuring it out and they're capturing those dollars. And so that's where I saw a lot of acceleration and growth for us, is because there are companies doing well and they're the ones that are able to figure out technology solutions. I don't know if anybody's been to a Chick-fil-A, but it's almost like they didn't skip a beat in the different ways you could order food and get things from them. And so that's kind of the exciting things that we're working on too now, is how do we use technology and rethink the ways we've been doing things in certain industries to be able to provide safer experiences and more convenient experiences for people.
Yeah, Sarah, we're almost out of time, so I want to give you a chance to give a shout out to your bosses, because clearly this starts with the leadership.
Yes.
What do your bosses bring to the table that makes the company so successful?
Well, I appreciate so much their directness. Like, they have an open door policy that they really are eager to hear from people about what we could do to make things better. And they really do empower folks. We all believe in, if you have a great solution and idea, don't wait for somebody to give you permission. Go ahead and enact it, and we'll give you the support you need to do it. So I think there's a lot about the way they treat everybody and they treat us, and it's top-down culture and leadership that makes Dialexa a great place to work.
Outstanding. We're going to absolutely have to have you back again. We're going to put the website up to end the segment. Dialexa.com is the website. Sarah Reid, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me. Great to be here.
You bet. That's it for now. We'll see you next time.